Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at how you can type special characters on your Mac. So let's look at how to type all sorts of special characters, anything that's not standard on your keyboard. And we'll start at the beginning here just with simple variations of characters, usually with accent marks and such. In Yosemite and in Mavericks before it, it's very easy to type these. All you need to do is pick the root letter, like say an E, and instead of tapping it on the keyboard, tap and hold down. And you get this little menu here of all the different variations. And then you can use the number underneath it to get the one you want. So for instance, I can tap 1 on the keyboard and I get that. I could have also selected it with the cursor to get it. So it's very easy to do that with any character, like for instance a Y or Z. Anything that's got a special variation will pop up with this, and you don't have to remember any special keyboard combination or go to any special place to get it. So for most text that you need to type in most languages that use Latin characters, you can very quickly get these special characters that way. Now, if you've used Macs for a while, you may remember that there are special ways to bring up these characters using the Option key. For instance, I can type Option E, and you see an accent mark appear, and it's actually even highlighted in yellow. And then I can type the letter E, and it puts it above it. You can do Option E again, and type an A, for instance. Now, the way to know these is either find a website that lists them all and kind of memorize them, but you could also bring up the keyboard viewer. And we're going to use both the keyboard and character viewer a lot in this, so let's go and add those. We want to go to System Preferences, go to Keyboard, and under the keyboard setting select Show Keyboard and Character Viewers in Menu Bar, and you'll see this icon appear here that allows us to bring those up. So now we can go and bring up the keyboard viewer, and this keyboard is something we can use to type by clicking on it with the mouse, but you can also see how it reacts when you hold down, say, the Shift key or the Option key. And here this clearly shows the special keys that have accent marks. So if I want to add this type of accent mark to any letter that uses it, you can see it's the I key, Option and I. So over here I'll do Option I and then I, and I get that character. So it's a quick way to learn these by using the keyboard viewer, just to see which keys turn orange when you hold down the Option key. But what if we want to go further than that and type all sorts of odd characters that aren't just simple variations? Well, you can use the keyboard viewer here and say look at the Option key and find things like there's the register trademark symbol, there's pi. You can do combinations like Option and Shift and find even more things like there's the Apple symbol. It's Option, Shift, and K. You can do that, but it will only reveal just a few that you can easily type. To reveal more, you want to go to the character viewer. And the character viewer brings up this whole control panel here that allows you to explore all the different characters and all the fonts on your machine. And you can select something like, say, arrows over here and then see all sorts of different arrows. And if you want to type one, all you need to do is double click it and it will insert it wherever it is that you're typing. Now, what's listed here on the left can be changed. So if mine looks different than yours, all you need to do is go to this settings menu here, customize the list, and you can see things that you can add or remove from this. So there's all sorts of different types of things that you can add here, like braille patterns, different arrows, dingbats, all sorts of different things. And what you do, it changes the menu over here. So I click on dingbats, and now I see all these cool little special characters. If I select them, not only do I get a larger view over here, but I could, as before, double click to add it. I could even drag and drop as well. So there's a lot of different things you can do, and you can select variations on here. So I'm seeing Webdings here, but I can do Webdings 2, going through all the different fonts that I've got installed on my Mac to see what's available. Now you can also search for characters, and search works reasonably well. You'll notice that some of these characters include some special text that accompanies it that will help in searches, but others do not. So for instance, if we're looking in Webdings here for things and we look at this, you know, we want to search for house, it doesn't come up, but we do get a couple of other variations, and you can see because that's kind of in the name there like that. So sometimes if you're looking for something special, you can find it by searching. Other times you can't. But you do have the ability to add things in to your favorites. You've got your recently used. You see ones I've recently used here. But also, say if we go into emoji here and we want to add something to our favorites, we can drag and drop into favorites there and it will appear. So now we can easily find it next time by, instead of searching for it in here, just clicking on favorites to see it listed. So you can also go in and search for something and then find variations on it. So for instance, if we look under bullets here and we want to find some sort of special bullet character, we can see related versions of it and variations. So there's different types of bullets. And sometimes variations are very similar to the one you've got, but they're just done with different fonts here. So you can kind of choose which font it is you're going to be accessing and say, well, I'm going to use the Arial one right here as opposed to using the one in Zaf Dingbats. Now you want to be careful when using some of the characters. They don't always work in all applications. Like for instance, these full color ones, like the emoji ones. You see, it works fine in TextEdit under Yosemite. If I were to switch to Pages and use the old Pages, you can see I can drag and drop and it won't work. Old Pages didn't support that. The new Pages, however, does support it.